Sportswoman is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Welcome back from that short commercial break. It is still Sportswoman. Before we went for the break, we were discussing the possibilities of our, you know, silverbacks and gazelles qualifying to the next level. Egypt beat Kenya 86-82. Uganda beat Rwanda 62-53. Yes, Adong, let's go straight away to the AFCON.
The first game?
The first game, briefly.
Well, for me, like I predicted here.
Did you predict because of patriotism, or
no,
you predicted because
not
of?
Because of not because of patriotism, but.
sorry,
she's that excited. She has forgotten her equipment.
Jesus Christ!
I am happy. Yes,
it's like a surgeon going into surgery without his couple.
Well, my prediction was basically on one factor that Zimbabwe, having looked at their squad first of all, even without watching them play, I had something in mind that Uganda would not beat Zimbabwe.
Congo.
I mean Zimbabwe first. Mm, first. That's why I had to go and bet. Mm. I mean predict that Uganda.
Bet.
Hey, I mean predict whatsoever, whether betting or predicting, but I don't bet, unfortunately.
I know, I thought you actually did the betting. That's what I was...
But I can guide. Well, fine. Bringing the point back home is that I predicted for Uganda Cranes to win against DRC Congo because I knew Uganda was not going to beat Zimbabwe. Given the team, given the familiarity of the squad, most of the players have been playing together for quite a long time in the South African League, and probably I thought maybe they're a little bit more pacey, more than our players. So having looked at Congo dropped more than its local best players, and they decided to go for all the so-called professionals.
Creme de la creme.
I knew Uganda would fidget with them there. And then the issue of the strike they had at first, you know what happened to them.
Yeah.
So I felt Uganda would do something to Congo, but I put it in mind that Uganda would not beat Zimbabwe, and indeed it happened yesterday. You saw even that draw that we got was a very, very good result for us, given the kind of play that Zimbabwe displayed, not for second half, that at least you had that kind of cooler game where Tadeo Luanga came in, tried to at least mesmerize in the midfielder to settle in after substituting Azira Mike. Yeah, so for me, basically, that was why I predicted that game that way.
Do you think we exhibited a good game yesterday?
Well, I cannot say we exhibited a very bad game, neither a very good game, because one, the players that I respected most failed to perform yesterday. I mean, each game comes with its own day. I want to quote Coach Dizabre, what he said, Sebastian, after the game in the conference. He said, Zimbabwe had a little bit more of advantage. They rested one day more than us, which is true. To football, because at least I work with a football club, I know what it means to rest. Mm. So if their players rested for 4 days, quite, and ours rested for only 3 days, and we had 2 days, and the third day we had to play. So definitely you'd understand his plea there. But again, also, the people like Mike Azira, who displayed a very good game against Congo. I don't know why the former Jogo player failed to do it. And then
they used a lot of energies.
Yes, they did a lot. And quite a number of chances that we missed there from Kadu himself. I do not want to blame Kadu at all for the rest of people are blaming him. Because technically, if you look at and tactically, if you look at the position at which he was, the ball was in the air, and you'd think,
but that would be a header. He would even put it on the chest.
And then the defenders were next to him. Maybe that fear was there. So you would not want to compare him to the goal that Musona missed, because so many people are saying, but Musona, you can't compare him to Musona. Yes, with it Musona, actually his was empty. There was no defender, but for him it was a minute, three defenders. Yes,
Sharon Olimba.
And
it was almost the
and
same.
Then there was a keeper ahead of him.
No, so I think for me, generally yesterday was actually a really bad movie.
Yes.
It was a continuation of the Twitter war between Zimbabwe and Uganda. Like it was such a horrible slugfest on Twitter. It was enjoyable for us, the rest of us, like being
another Mubumoli,
like seeing things from another, you know, angle. I mean, it was interesting from that angle, but I mean, it was such a horrible slugfest of slugging each other, abusing each other, like taking the, I mean, the, what, okay, some people
that
say
country,
the peace
country,
out of each other.
That irrigates, uses this for irrigation cannot beat us.
We are all poor, we all have poor GDP.
Our presidents have also.
And it showed in our football to a certain extent, because you get a team like Egypt, and you hand them all those four opportunities that Uganda looked in the Uganda and Zimbabwe looked in the face and wasted. They would never. At least one of those opportunities should have been taken. I felt like it was so disappointing for me. Yes, I wanted Uganda to win so bad, but Knowledge Musona, you are a professional. There is a reason why your name is Knowledge.
Knowledge.
And it is not idiot.
And Musona should have just killed it all.
Composure, composure. No Lionel Messi or Cristiano Ronaldo is going to try and lace that ball. Just take the ball down and take your shot. I mean, and it's the same thing with Patrick Kadu. And this is why I mean, on social media, I remember telling myself, you know what, Mrs. Okwi Patrick, I mean, Okwi Kadu Mia. Honestly,
Lumala Pogba. The name I love most is the one Lumala Pogba.
I take that back, because I felt like, for all the good things Kadu did in game one, I'm sorry he undid them for me. I still have faith in him. I still feel like he's an okay striker, but he really showed a lack of experience playing at that level.
Someone said that Kadu missed a chance of going to Europe yesterday.
I don't know why Kadu was trying to do too much. I mean, I'm
he wanted to do.
I'm a very simple.
The Geoffrey Massa style. Remember Massa?
Simplicity.
Of tearing the nets.
Efficiency. We do not need people to be scoring bicycle kicks. People trying to be memorable. That was not.
No, but you
that.
Know his name.
I know.
Should I put
I
his
know.
Name
I
on
I know.
Air
next time. Well.
Next time better. Okay.
That was not the moment for that. I felt like we missed an opportunity. I would have wanted for us to go face Egypt, knowing we are in the round of 16. If we go and waste it, put that on us.
On the other side, I am disappointed that Zimbabwe is not going to make it on the top 16, probably. That is if they
have manage. A chance.
They have a
very huge chance, because
they
win against Congo
by three goals.
I don't think Congo is going to be all that so low. Really, honestly speaking.
And Congo also still
to allow
to become that in the group. So
yes.
Congo is not going
to step all that so low to allow Zimbabwe to just go and step on them like that. So basically, the game against Congo and Zimbabwe, Mr. Biliat and Musona Knowledge should take it into account that me, I am going to stand with the Congolese.
Okay, so what does Cranes need?
What Cranes need is
we
what?
We need for Zim to lose.
We need Zimbabwe to lose.
Adong.
Yes, Zimbabwe has to lose. Yes, that's what I'm saying.
My only issue was I would have loved for Uganda.
Zimbabwe
to
should
into,
not win.
I would have loved for Uganda to go into the Egypt game with a level points to them, because I would have wanted to see that team playing with no pressure but wanting to win, because I mean, Egypt are at home, but. You realize they have more pressure than us who are not at home, because their fans demand it of them.
Actually, Egyptians, let me tell you, if there's any country Egypt would not love to face at this moment so much, is Uganda Cranes. Because they've tested it all. Our World Cup qualifiers, how they cheated us, I'm sorry, I'm putting it open here. How we were cheated in Cairo, that one was kind of theft that would really see happening to any East African countries.
Before
so
we link to
we are
back,
going to pay back.
Who was your man of the match?
My man of the match is Dennis Onyango Masinde. Reasons why I'm giving him man of the match, despite the fact that all other departments, especially the midfield and the defense, had fallen out completely, Dennis Onyango played everything. Yeah? Look at those crucial saves that he made, especially this other one that he turned and came and tapped it when it was on the line like this. Honestly speaking, very few goalkeepers in the world would do. Actually, someone tweeted that if it was Peter Cech of England, of Arsenal, former Arsenal and Chelsea, that would have been a goal. Yes, someone tweeted it, I'm telling you.
2005
Someone tweeted it.
2004 Cech. You cannot joke with the essence of Peter Cech. Yes, I know.
Yes,
Arsenal,
of those days, yes. Of those days. But not the Peter Cech of this one.
Even of this
was
days.
Just gone. No. Peter Cech would not save
even
that goal. That's
days.
A fact.
No, actually, I was going to say, was that a lucky bounce? Because. The way that ball bounced, that's
what Onyango,
he turned
on the ground.
No, what I'm saying, his initial save was so good, but I'm saying the bounce of the ball was also a little on the, you know, the lucky side. Let's be honest, because normally a ball bounces, it goes further forward, but that ball bounced and sat on the line. Yes, Onyango, hindsight 100%, she did the very good job of going back and getting it back, and I believe certain people were saying Onyango could save our economy.
Okay, so Mr.
And
Zofin,
even the kind of player that you managed to pull the pressure down.
I would go Onyango for Uganda, but then I would go Kamabiliat for Zimbabwe. It was really impressive.
Yeah. Okay, then what are your predictions? Cranes playing Egypt on Sunday.
Honestly, I think we could win it. I've said it. We could win it. 1-0. But in the event that we don't win it, 1-1 is okay.
Mm. We are sharing the spoils there.
1-0.
We are sharing.
Okay, Kale. Yes. Anyway, how about Madagascar versus Burundi? We have Senegal, Algeria, and Kenya, Tanzania.
Kenya, Tanzania, I go for Kenya. Having looked at the game of Tanzania, I didn't understand what kind of game they were playing against Senegal. The same applied to Kenya. The game they played against Algeria, they were good at marathon. Actually, I tweeted, I said, guys, I think we are watching marathon here. But still, now, when these two East African teams meet, Kenya looked to be a little bit more solid, a little bit more tougher. Tanzania has only one Samata, and the other ones have at least a variety. So I would go for Kenya in that game. And then Madagascar, you said Madagascar, Burundi. I would go for Madagascar.
Madagascar?
Yeah.
K.I.?
I would go, this for me, what I've noticed about this competition is, and I say this about every derby I've been involved in, whether you're looking at a situation of the derby in Europe, all these things, Kenya, Tanzania, you can never know. I feel like it's going to be up in smoke, tense. Both teams want a point, so I think it's going to be a draw in my opinion.
Rating Mochibi, Mugabe, and Lumala, who have not been part of this team. Who has impressed you?
I would go with Bevis.
Because they play different positions.
Yes, I know.
Because they've not been
been with the team.
I'd say Bevis is one who has shocked me because he has handled, he has come down to our level pretty well. Like, honestly, he has, the way he has joined up with his teammates, you don't feel like he doesn't play with them. But, let's be honest, the thing that impresses me the most, though, is Lumala's brilliance on the wing. I've not seen a Ugandan who I see with the ball and I'm like, go on, boy, do what you can
Mochibi,
with the ball.
Mochibi, honestly, yesterday looked he a was, visitor in the team.
I felt like he was very shaky.
To me, he looked a visitor in the team.
Okay, let's link to Osbat on the timeline to give us what is happening.
Yes, good afternoon, ladies. Glad to be on set with you for the first time. And I must say, you look beautiful for spots.
Oh, you look scared.
He's scared.
I'm scared. I'm scared of fearing. I'm scared of fearing the boss headmate. The boss headmate put me on the spot.
Anyway, fine. It is okay, Osbat. Osbat, it is fine. The viewers have seen who the Osbat we've been talking about is.
Yeah.
Let's go for a short commercial break. We will be right back.
Sportswoman is brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.